Floyd was an interesting thing for us. We were a young band in Arizona, and we came to L.A. And like every other band, we were trying to get a gig, any gig at all, any gig. And we struggled and struggled and struggled. Finally, we got a gig at the Whiskey A Go-Go, right? And we got there and we looked up at the sign and it said, Alice Cooper and Led Zeppelin. Who's Led Zeppelin? Yeah. The very next night, we're playing the Cheetah Club. Alice Cooper and Pink Floyd? Must be a guy who dresses in pink. And, you know, the truth is, we had Piper at the Gates of Dawn. It's an underground album. We got it from, and we loved Sid Barrett. We might have been the only people in L.A. that knew who Pink Floyd was. So when we saw we were playing with him, we were like that. We had exactly the same light show. It was like a guy playing this and all the lights were uplights. So when we did our shows, those shows were very similar, you know. And they basically ran out of money and moved in with us. Bob Ezrin produced Schools Out and The Wall. So when we were doing Schools Out, and at the end, I said, you know, what The Wall is saying is the same thing that Schools Out is saying. And they go like this. The two songs go like that. When we play the end of Schools Out, it's da 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 da. We don't need no education. Da 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 da. We end the show with that every night, and the audience goes crazy because Bob produced both of them. So when we connected them up, it was a perfect fit. Nobody sounded like Pink Floyd. I mean, a lot of people sounded like other bands at that time. A lot of blues rock. People were trying to sound like The Doors or Love or whoever it was at the time, but nobody sounded like Pink Floyd. They were Stockhausen. They were, you know, they were all these electronic things going on, but it made sense. Pink Floyd were the space guys. You know, I mean, they were really out. They were out in some other dimension. And Pink Floyd certainly, like I said, nobody sounded like them. Because it sounded chaotic at points, but when you really listened to the structure of the song, it was a great song. Pink Floyd, with the way that they work, an orchestra behind Pink Floyd would be insane. Now you're taking it to another level, see? I mean, before you were confined to a keyboard, guitar, bass, drums, and you can do only so much with that. Synthesizer, you can do a lot. When then you go, now you can work with 60 more instruments. Well, now you can just go crazy with it. You can have as much fun as you want to. When you're doing one of your songs and all of a sudden you hear that orchestra kick in, it literally shocks you a little bit. You go, what was that? You better listen, because I know where you live.